Hey guys, let's get personal. This is a video that I've been wanting to do for a long, long time. This is a video that I've already made one version of that is no longer available on YouTube because I accidentally removed it. And this is a video that has been long overdue. This is a video I think you guys deserve, you guys have been asking for, and I have maybe lacked a bit of the courage, a little of the time, and a little bit of the willingness to make it. But that's it. For now, we're gonna go through with it and I'm gonna talk to you about the topic that I get asked a lot about, especially when I stream, especially on my social medias, which is weight loss. It is not a secret for those of you guys who know me that I have been a very, very big guy. I used to be overweight. I used to weigh a lot of kilos. In fact, I've been at 130 kilos when I was at my most. At least that's what the scale said, assuming it wasn't lying, even though that I wish. And now I'm down to a more healthy weight. When I was at my lowest, actually, I was at 69. So in theory, I've lost 61 kilos, which I could imagine some of you guys watching out there, you know, you may not even weigh 61 kilos. So it's basically losing an entire person of fat and stuff you don't want on your body. So if you relate to it like that, it's quite ridiculous to think about that it even got to the point where I was at 130 kilos. Anyhow, enough with that. As I said, it's a video that has been long overdue. It's a video that I've been wanting to make for a long, long time. But I was thinking about how to do it right, because I have an audience that follows me on my stream, that follows me on my social medias, that range between anything from 10, 11, 12 years old to people who are 34, 45, you name it, right? So I wanted to make a video where people can relate to what I'm saying, no matter if you're 12 years old or if you're 35 years old. I don't care. This should be a video that you should be able to relate to, and I should talk about some of the experiences I've had. Both as a person, of course, it's getting very personal, not gonna lie, but also as a professional gamer, in the sense that I used to play professional Counter-Strike. So for those of you who are unaware who I am, or for those of you who are relatively new to me and what the PimpCSGO brand is, let me give you a short introduction so you can sort of like follow the timeline. I'm Jacob Pim Vinicke, and I've been a professional Counter-Strike player for 7 years. I used to play for, or I have played for teams like Dignitas, SK Gaming. I played for Team Liquid. That was my most recent team that I played for. I've been a stand-in for Astralis, standing for Heroic. Been playing for some of the top organizations out there and been considered one of the best players in the world when I was in my peak shape. Unfortunately for me, I couldn't keep up with that level. Lost a bit of the motivation. Lost a bit of the willingness to work as hard as I did in the beginning of my career, and I went from being a player that I think a lot of people, you know, at least in peak performance, thought was a top 20 player in the world, to be a guy that was still good, a guy that was still a top 100 player without a doubt, but not at the level where it was satisfying for myself to compete at. When I compete, I want to be the absolute best at what I do. I'm not satisfied being number 38 or 34 or number 22. I want to be number one, and I lost faith at a certain point in my career that I could be the number one player in the world, and for me that was enough to, I guess, to lose the willingness to work hard. Anyhow, we're not going to talk about my career that much, because that's not really what is interesting about this, because I don't consider my professional career as a Counter-Strike player to be the greatest achievement that I've ever made. Without a doubt, the greatest achievement I've ever done is losing weight. Without a doubt, going from 130 kilos to 69 kilos, which is not a healthy weight, but let's talk about that later, is without a doubt the greatest achievement that I've ever done. It's without a doubt the feeling and the feeling of satisfaction that has filled my body with the most joy throughout my entire life. I've been at 6 majors, I've been at some big tournaments, I placed first at some smaller Danish tournaments, some local events, small international tournaments. I've been in finals of big international events as well, and I've achieved a lot as a Counter-Strike player and as an analyst and a full-time streamer, which is what I'm doing right now. I've been filled with a lot of joy, you know, a lot of excitement and a lot of, dare I say, proudness from some of the achievements that I've had, but nothing comes close to what I feel about having been able to go from this big, big guy to the more healthy version of who I am right now. And let's go with that, right? I was a big dude. I was a fat guy. I was very, very fat. I weighed 130 kilos and I was as unhealthy as you can be. To give you guys some relatable examples, I'm going to be very personal. I'm going to give you, you know, a timeline of what I could do in a day, and I'm going to give you stuff that you maybe or maybe not can relate to. You may be sitting out there watching this video being a little bit overweight yourself, wanting to lose weight. Well, my goal with this video is to inspire you, or at least tell you my version of what I did, that you can pick parts of. You can, you know, you can think, okay, this I can relate to, this I don't understand, and you can basically pick apart this video and use whatever you can in order to fit into your life, in order for you potentially to be a healthier version of yourself. Anyhow, that's how I'm imagining this video could help you, and I hope that is the case when you're done watching it. It's gonna be a longer one, so bear over with me, but I think I'm quite interesting to listen to when it comes to this subject. Anyway, a normal day for me when I was, you know, 14, 15 years old would be going to school, you know, eating a lot of snacks and all that kind of stuff when I was in school. My mom was not aware, my dad was not aware. I'm sure they would have been thinking at some point, you know, okay, we feed this kid with more or less normal food, but he's just twice the size as everyone else. That is, of course, because I went there back and I went to the gas station and I bought, you know, a slice of pizza. I went to the grocery shop and bought a cake. I went to the hot dog, you know, facilities and bought a hot dog on my way home from school and all that kind of stuff. I was eating a lot of cakes and I was eating a lot of chips. So it, like, a day for me would not be unreasonable to go to school, you know, eat my lunch that my mom packed for me, and then also eat a cake on top of that, also eat a bag of chips on top of that. After school, I would go to the grocery store, you know, buy a couple of bags of chips, you know, put them down in my school bag, go home, sit in front of my PC, eat another bag of chips, and then go down, eat dinner, and then go up on my room again, play some more computer games, and eat a third bag of chips. You know, that wouldn't be unreasonable to say that could have been any given day in my life back then, which when I think back on it, is just ridiculous, right? Because I could never ever do that today. But that was the bad habit I was into. I was the guy that people would point towards. You would be like, you'd be seeing me on the street and you'd be thinking to yourself, oh, I feel so sorry for that kid. He's gonna have a miserable life. Or you'd be looking towards the guy and think, oh, Jesus, you fat kid. Why don't you do something about it? You know, there's always those two versions. It would even be as bad as some of the, you know, the kids that I'd encounter would be like, mom, that guy over there, he's pretty fat, isn't he? And they'll be like, shh, you can't say that. You know, I was that guy. You can relate. Like, you've seen a guy like that in the streets before. And to be quite honest with you, I didn't pay attention to that. I didn't notice that people would think that of me. But I know they did, right? It's just about being straight up honest here. I'm not going to sugarcoat anything. I'm sure you guys can relate to this. You've seen a guy where you thought to yourself, oh, Jesus, I wish this guy would just do something about it so he never have a better life, you know? And that is a good thought to have, and as long as you don't, you know, rub it in whoever the guy is face, or as long as you keep those thoughts to yourself, you're not doing anything wrong. So let me be clear about that one. But I was that guy. I turned out to be a professional Counter-Strike player. As said, I was up where it was really, really fun. I was playing on one of the best teams in the world when CSGO came out. We were placed second at a lot of the big tournaments. I think we were second on the world rankings as well. A team called Western Wolves back in the days. Been playing for Team Liquid, been playing for with the Astralis guys and something called Copenhagen Wolves before they became TSM and then Astralis. So I've been around the international Counter-Strike scene basically my entire life. When I stopped playing Counter-Strike, I instantly transitioned into becoming a part-time streamer and a full-time analyst. So I've been traveling the world and I've been watching a lot of Counter-Strike, and I've been traveling a lot. And that's something we're going to talk about later as well, because traveling and playing computer games and doing that for a living, well, let's put it as an obstacle. That's not easy to handle if you want to lose weight. But let's rewind the time a little bit. In those first 4 years of my professional career, I was the big guy. I was the guy that was, you know, playing computer games. I was pretty goddamn good at it. I was still traveling the world. I was still going to tournaments. But every time you saw my face on the stream, every time you saw my face in the television, you'd see a big obese guy. You'd see a guy that potentially was happy in the moment. He was happy that he was sitting on a stage. He was happy that he was playing Counter-Strike for a living, but he wasn't happy about his life. He wasn't happy about his posture, and he wasn't happy about the fact that he knew that he was a big guy. You know, something as simple as going to school. I remember that our classroom was on the second floor, which means that I had to walk up four different staircases to go to our classroom. And I was so afraid that every single time that I would enter my classroom, my back would be all sweaty, you know, so you could see that I've been sweating just because I have to walk up the four staircases, because I was sweating, you know, there's no hiding that. I was so obese, I was so big that I couldn't walk up the stairs without sweating, grasping for my air and all that kind of stuff. But I wanted to hide it, you know. So you live a life where you constantly try to hide the fact that you're uncomfortable about the fact that you're fat. You're uncomfortable about the fact that you are, you know, obese. You're uncomfortable around the fact that you are, like, even when we gather down in the school, right, you have those gatherings in the morning where all the classes are gathered up together. If I would sit down, I would make sure, if I could, to sit on the outside of the chairs at all times. Because if I was sitting in the middle and I had a chair row to my right and a chair row to my left, well, that means that I would be picking up a chair and a half, you know. So some of the dudes that would have to sit next to me, they would have to sit like this in order to fit in. And I wanted to hide the fact that I was that big. I knew it. And that's why I was very cautious about it. But try imagine having a life where you constantly walk around and the only thing you think about is, how do I hide the fact that I'm as big as I am? How do I make sure that no one else feels uncomfortable around me? Because I don't feel comfortable around myself, you know. That thought and thinking like that, that is so unhealthy for your psyche. That's so unhealthy mentally. And that's something that I want to, like, I really, really, really want to stress out that if you're at that spot right now, if you can relate to this feeling, do me a favor right now, you know, stop the video, pause the video and think about, is that really worth it? Is that all you want out of your life? Or is there more to it? Because I can tell you, you know, I've been on that side, and that's what I like the most about this little transition I made, or bigger transition, that I can relate to both sides now. I've been the big fat guy in school, you know, when I was supposed to go to parties, when I was supposed to have the best time of my life, I was sitting at home playing computer games, and I made a career out of that. I made it to be, you know, one of the 0.001 players in Counter-Strike Source, or Counter-Strike Global Offensive, sorry, that was as good as I were, but I also missed the aspect of having a social life, you know. Think about it, is it worth it, you know? Because the answer is clearly, no, it's not worth it. If you have that feeling, you gotta do something about it, and you gotta do something actively about it. Unfortunately for me, I had to have that feeling for 3 or 4 years before it really, you know, clicked in my brain that I was no longer willing to walk around like that. So I was at my gymnasium state at school. I think you can relate that to high school, or maybe the first year of college, you know, you're in that age where girls are supposed to be fun, you know, parties are supposed to be what you live for, and all that kind of stuff. But my entire world was basically surrounding, you know, Counter-Strike and eating as many cakes and chips as I possibly could. The Counter-Strike part, fantastic. Love it. I wouldn't be without it. As said, I made it as a pro player, and I'm really, really proud of that. But the whole, you know, being obese, the whole being big, definitely not worth it. So when I got into my third and final year of school, I don't know what it was, but something was just, you know, I've been wanting to lose weight for a long time, but I just haven't been able to. So, you know, something clicked in my brain, and finally I got that little, you know, kickstart that I needed to lose the weight. Now, I've always been very much into sports. I've always been very much into football, handball, which we play a lot in Denmark. If you're watching this from America or Canada, you may not know what that sport is. Google it. Anyhow, it's a very popular sport in Denmark, and I was quite good at handball when I was younger. I was quite good at football when I was younger. I think I can even show you here on my Instagram, you know, some old pictures. We'll go back and watch some of those later on as well. But I did play a lot of sports, you know. Just to give you an idea, this was a picture of me in Copenhagen Wolves. This was when I was really, really big. You know, I was not at my top here, but I was still a big guy. As more videos like that, as you progress, this is me playing in a team called 3D Max. This is me on the beach, you know. I'll go as far as saying it. Being on a beach when you have this size is one of the most uncomfortable feelings in the world. The fact that I don't have a shirt on right here, I don't know who, you know, who took that picture. I don't know how they convinced me to let it stand, but that's how it went down. So we'll return to the Instagram later. For now though, that was a few examples of how big I were. Anyhow, I started to lose weight. I was way into sports. I was way into handball, football, cycling for that matter as well. And like my big motivation, my biggest driver, my driving factor, which is something that you guys need to consider as well. If you use this video for the purpose of losing weight yourself, because you're overweight, then just pause the video again right now and think to yourself, what is it that motivates me? Why is it you don't want to be big? Is it because you have those, you know, mental challenging thoughts in your head that I just described? Is it because you cannot play football with your friends? Is it because you don't ever think you're going to get a girlfriend? Is it because you can't play football with your mates? Is it because you can't walk up the stairs without sweating? You know, for me, it was all those reasons. For me, it was all those reasons put together in one big circle that then made me, you know, made me made me want it so much that even though it was incredible hard in the beginning, and even though, you know, not eating the chips, not drinking the cola, not drinking the soda, not doing all the cakey stuff, you know, it was the combination of all the things that I wanted to achieve with my life and all the things that I wanted to do outside of playing Counter-Strike that was the driving factor, that was the catalyst for me and my journey of losing weight, sort of. So I think it's important that you, again, pause the video now, think to yourself, what is it you want to achieve? Why is it you're watching this video in the first place? If it's because you want to hear my story, then thank you so much for taking part in this. I hope you guys are going to be willing to share this video, you know, link it to your mates, share it in groups where it makes sense, you know, or use it on your school or whatever that may be, you know. But if you're one of those guys who were like me when you're young, you know, pause the video now and think to yourself, what is it that could be the big motivation for you guys? Because I think that's very important to have an idea about before you start losing weight. Because if you don't know why you want to lose weight, you just want to lose weight because you're obviously not happy about being a big guy, or you're obviously not happy about not having a six pack or whatnot, then I don't think that's enough for many people. At least not for me. I needed that, you know, strong driving factor. I needed that strong willingness in order to do it and achieve it. And I had to combine all these different things that I wanted to do in order for it to outweigh, you know, the cakes. Because the cakes and the chips and the living unhealthy was always up here, you know. Eating a slice of pizza was like, highlight of my day. So it was always up here. So I had to build up the way so it could scale down like this, you know. So now the motivation, now the fact that I wanted to play football, the fact that I wanted to be in school and not feel bad about myself, the fact that I didn't want my parents to think that I was a failure, all that kind of stuff now weighed higher than this, right? So you gotta find that, you know, gotta find that balance so you can basically overrule what should be the bad stuff over here, which is the pizzas, the eating unhealthy all the time, and so forth. Very important for me to say that that's something you should think about. Now, losing weight can be done in a lot of different ways. And I don't think I did it in the most healthy and the best way I could. This is me, again, being very honest. This is me, you know, telling you about my story, my journey, so hopefully you guys can learn from your mistakes. Because as I showed you before, right, if we took a look at my Instagram, there were some pictures where I was very big. Let's be honest, sorry. Right here. You're looking at me, you know, eating a slice of pizza, right? And I would do this more or less every day, and that was fine. Now, you can eat a slice of pizza and still lose weight, but you can also do like I did and just go all in, you know, which is all in with a day off. So instead of looking like this, I turned out to look like this, which I'm very happy about. Don't get me wrong here, but I was not healthy, you know. I was not necessarily healthy in the beginning. Look at this right here. That is me when I was at my lowest. That is me when I was at my lowest. You would not look at that guy on your screen right here and think he's a healthy boy. You look at that guy and think he's not healthy, right? He's not eating correctly and he's not healthy, simple as it is. And I would agree with you. There's no difference between looking like this guy and, again, looking like this guy. To me, those guys are both unhealthy. But I'll talk to you about that right here, right now. Because you can lose weight in different ways. What I did was that I stopped. In the beginning, I stopped eating as much as I did before. Because there's no doubt that I was eating dinner, I was eating lunch, I was eating breakfast, and I also had all these snacks, you know, in between. So I cut down on all the snacks. I didn't eat a bag of chips. I didn't eat the extra cake on my way home. I didn't eat the hot dog home from school. I basically cut down on all the unnecessary food that didn't, like, it didn't do anything for me, right? It wasn't like the food made me feel full. It wasn't like the food made me feel good. It was basically just bad conscience. I would eat the hot dog, think while I was eating it, oh, why are you doing this, you idiot? So I just stopped doing that. So that was the first step. I took away all the, you know, all the unhealthy stuff in that sense, right? I took away all the snacks. I took away the soda. For me, drinking diet products helped me a lot. You know, I still wanted that, you know. You guys know it. It's a satisfying feeling of you know, drinking a glass of Coca-Cola or a glass of Pepsi or whatever you may be into. But you could do that in a diet way, you know, with no calories in it. And calories is another important thing that I'm going to talk about later. Because how do you lose weight? Well, it's quite simple. You gotta eat less calories than you consume, right? So me getting rid of the bag of chips, getting rid of the cakes, getting rid of the hot dogs, getting rid of all that kind of stuff, most likely made me go from eating, could be 4,000 calories a day or 4,500 if I was really, really disgusting, to, okay, cut that out and now I just eat breakfast, dinner, lunch, all the kind of stuff, all the normal stuff, you know. Now I would be eating 3,000 calories a day. maybe 2,800 calories a day. Now, the problem for me is that at that time, I couldn't exercise, right? I was still big. I was still a guy that was too big to play football, too big to go for any bike rides or anything like that. So I was maybe only burning 2,500 calories a day. So I was in a surplus of 300. And you gotta get below, right? If you wanna lose fat, if you wanna lose weight, you gotta consume less calories than you burn. It's that simple. Don't listen to anyone. And again, let me be very clear about this. There's definitely some fitness experts out there. There's definitely some training gurus out there who know everything there is to know about nutrition, about fitness, about health. But one thing that I've learned throughout of all this, because I'm very interested in as well, is that there's no right or wrong in the sense that for some people, it works to count your calories. And for some people, it does not work to count your calories. So if you're one of those guys who like to count your calories, and you're being constantly told by your friends or the experts out there that you shouldn't count calories because that's unhealthy in itself, shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. If that is helping this individual to achieve his goal, to lose the weight and basically get to the place where he want to be, you are in no position to tell him that's unhealthy as well. The same thing with diet Pepsi, diet Coke, or diet Faxacondi Free, whatever you may drink out there. If me drinking, let's say, a liter of Pepsi Max a day, you know, that's not healthy. We can easily agree that water is better than Pepsi Max. Simple. But if that makes me avoid drinking a liter of normal Pepsi with a lot of calories in a day, then that is healthy for me. That is healthy in my, you know, in my prospect of reaching a new place in my life. So don't listen to anyone else than people that you can relate to or people that has your best interest at heart. Don't listen to the guys that says you're doing this wrong, you're doing this wrong, you're doing this wrong, just because they don't agree with that. Be nuanced. Think about it. If it's helping you, well, if it's getting you closer to the place where you want to be, then do it. And that, for me, for an example, a great example is the Pepsi Max. I was drinking maybe a liter, maybe a liter and a half every single day. Every single day. We can agree that's not healthy, but every single day when I was still losing weight, every single day. In the period of the 1 year when I lost 60 kilos, I would say that I probably did down average a liter of diet soda every single day. So you can do that. You can do that. May not be better than water, but if you need that little fix in order for you not to drink the soda with calories in, or for you not to eat that sugary cake or whatever the hell that may be, then do that. You know, find alternatives to the stuff you do that you're doing right now in order to change it. Because that, you know, cut away 500 calories from my daily intake, and all of a sudden I was below what I needed to be at. Truth to be told is that I didn't count calories in the beginning because I had no idea what counting calories was. I learned that in the middle of the whole project. Now, but I did start to eat less, and I did start to feel hungry. And this is something that I'm sure a lot of you guys can relate to if you're as big as I were, or if you're getting to the point where you're as big as I were. I forgot the feeling of hungry. I didn't know how it felt to be hungry. I can literally not think back. When I was 14 years old to 18 years old, I can probably count five times out of like, what, 1,200, 1,300 days where I felt hunger, when I was hungry, because I was constantly eating. So my body never told me, hey, Jacob, you need some fuel now. I'm hungry. I need some food, because it was already stuffed up with a lot of food. So the fact that I learned and I trained myself that it was okay to be hungry for half an hour, maybe even an hour and a half, you know, before you got food in your system, that was a game changer for me. Because now I could even it out during the day, right? Instead of eating breakfast at 8 a.m., then eat lunch at, you know, 12, and then eat a lot of snacks throughout the day and eat dinner at 7, you know, I could eat breakfast at, you're 9, you know, I could wait until I got to school. I could eat lunch, you know, when I got home from school. So all of a sudden, I basically stretched out the meals to, you know, make me feel longer for the days, because it was okay to be hungry for half an hour. It was okay to be hungry for an hour. I didn't have to eat instantly. I felt hunger. And that was a game changer for me, because that made me sure that I didn't eat too much, you know. So I was eating until I was no longer hungry, but I wasn't eating until I was full. It was not like I was eating dinner and I was like, ugh, I can't no more. Because you're not going to lose weight like that. You got to cut down on your calories. You got to cut down on the food you take in. And you got to eat, you know, less than you burn. Simple as it is. So my eating habits got a lot better. but I wouldn't necessarily say they were healthy. As I said just before when I talked about losing weight, I don't think I did it in the most healthy way because I was eating too little. I think I was at a certain point, you know, down to 1500 to 1600 calories a day while also doing exercises more or less every day, which means that my daily calorie intake should be roughly around 2500, 2600, but I only got 1500, which means that I was in a deficit of 1000 calories every single day, more or less. If you are that, you're gonna lose weight, and you're gonna lose weight fast, at least I did, but you're also gonna lose all your muscles. There's no way that the body can retain the little muscle that I have, or the muscle that I'm trying to build up while doing the exercises on the pad. Problem for me was I didn't want to strength train. I didn't like strength training back then. I didn't go to the gym, I didn't lift any weights, but what I did was I was walking, I was biking, and I was running when I could, you know. Of course, in the beginning, I could only walk. So I started to go for like 10 minute, 15 minute, 20 minute walks. Then I started to go for 10 minute walk, 1 minute run, you know, 5 minute walks, 2 minutes run. And I basically slowly but surely added another layer all the time. So at a point I could now start to run, you know, I could run for 10 minutes and I wouldn't run fast. I wouldn't run far, but I would be running. I would be running, but I didn't do any gym activities whatsoever. So me being in such a big calorie deficit while also doing exercises, well, it burned all the fat away from my body, which you can see. Again, let's just quickly take a look at this picture, right? Because it's quite scary. There's not a lot of fat on this body. There's basically nothing. There's not a lot of muscles on this body. I would even argue that this picture is probably not the worst one I can find, but it's the only one I have available on my Instagram. But you can see I am so small. I'm so skinny. Nothing is left. And that is exactly why I started going to the gym, because I knew that the way I was losing weight was not necessarily the most healthy way of doing it. And I'm happy. I'm happy I didn't do it the best way, sort of. I'm happy I didn't do it the way that, you know, the perfect way, where you go to the gym 4 times a week, you do biking, you know, twice a week, and you like do everything correct, because I learned from those mistakes, you know. I learned from those mistakes and I achieved my goal anyway. So again, if you are one of those guys who are watching this video wanting to lose, it could be 10 kilos, it could be 50 kilos. I don't know how severe your case is or how severe your problem is. But again, do yourself a favor. After I'm done telling you this, pause the video and think to yourself, well, what is the most important thing for you to achieve? Is that to lose the weight? Is that for you to lose the fat and then you can build up your muscle afterwards? Or is that to do it the perfect way where you build on muscle, you lose fat and you end up, you know, looking like a strong man afterwards, you know? Because it's okay if you can do that. If you have the willpower, if you have the information, if you have the willingness, if you can do it that way, I would applaud you and I would say, great, that is the right way for you to do it. But I don't think I could. I couldn't have done it if I also had to go to the gym. I couldn't have done it if I also had to think about, oh, well, maybe I need to eat a little more now because I don't want to lose too much muscles and blah, 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 blah. I didn't give a flying damn about it. What I did was that I lost as much weight as fast as I possibly could because I felt good about that. I was stepping up on the scale every single morning and you could just see it go like this. And that in itself for me was motivation enough to keep at it. So sure, there'll be critics out there. There'll be guys sitting in my YouTube comments now saying, Jacob, you didn't do it properly. Jacob, you should have done this, should have done that. And what you did was just as unhealthy as eating chips and sodas and all that kind of stuff. To hell with that. To hell with that. I had a goal. My goal was to lose weight. I did that. I had a goal. My goal was to be able to play football, play handball, you know, potentially get a girlfriend sometime in the future, feel good about myself. And guess what? I'm sitting right here, right now, and I play football. I play handball. I'm in the shape of my life. It's much, what is it, like 2 weeks ago, I ran a 5 kilometer in 18 minutes and 6 seconds. If you would have told me that I would be able to achieve that 6 years ago, I would probably have laughed at you and thought to myself that you are the biggest idiot that I've ever met. But I am able to do that because I did the first goal I had, which was losing weight. Then afterwards, I could build up some muscle, you know. You look at me right now, right? It's not a secret. I can expose myself right here. I don't have a lot of muscle, you know. This is what I can do. This is going to be such a bad picture you guys can take. Anyway, this is what I can do. So I'm not big. I'm not muscular. I'm not, you know, a guy that goes to the gym to get big. because I don't care. I don't want to be that guy. I want to be a guy that's in great shape. I want to be a guy that is able to bike a lot, that is able to run a lot, and I want to be good at football, because right now I find football super, super fun to play. Again, if you're from America, it's called soccer, and you guys are weird about it. Anyway, you got to find out, and I guess the moral of the story here, sorry, you got to find out what is important to you, because if it's important to you to look good, you know, be muscular and be attractive in that sense, if that's something that you find nice, do it. Set up your goal, achieve it, and do it the way that you think is the right way to do it, as long as you can monitor your result, right? As long as you can see that the scale is going down, you're losing fat, and your muscle, you know, your muscle mass or whatever that may be is going up. All that kind of stuff is super, super cool. But let me emphasize it one more time. We are individuals. I am Jacob Pim Vindicke. My eyes are fucked up. My mind is, you know, it is what it is. You guys have been watching me on Twitch. You know who I am. You know what I stand for. At least some of you do. I am myself. I'm my own personality. I am Jacob, right? I am not Kevin. I am not Matilda. I'm not someone else. I'm not someone else. So whatever works for me, works for me. And those are the experience that I can talk about. Those are the experience that I can make you guys relate to. And some of you guys may be thinking out there right now, okay, what he said about, you know, losing weight but not caring about muscle, I can relate to that. But when he said that about football, I don't want to play football. What the hell? Like, take whatever you can from this video. Take whatever you can from this story. Use it actively yourself. And then ignore the rest. Because you're all individuals out there. And I respect that. Again, there will be guys telling you that, don't listen to Jacob. He does not know what he's talking about. But I do. I live that life. As I said, I've been on this side and I've been on this side. I've been the big guy that nobody wanted to be around. I've been the big guy that felt so uncomfortable that I didn't want to be around anyone. And now I'm over here. I'm a guy that, like, if I don't meet with anyone throughout an entire day, I almost get social anxiety. You know, I want to be, it's a lie, of course, but I want to be together with people. I like being social. I like being around people. I like engaging with new people, you know, friends, old friends, you name it. I wasn't that guy, you know, 6 years ago. So you got to figure out what works for you, what's best for me, and don't necessarily listen to all the guys that are self-proclaimed experts, you know, count your macros, do this. If you eat too much 2 grams too much of fat, you're not going to get down to this fat percent. Shut up. It doesn't matter. If you're at a stage where you just want to lose weight, it doesn't matter. It does not matter. If you're at a stage where you want to optimize your body, if you're at a stage where you're chasing, I wouldn't necessarily say perfection, but you're chasing new goals, which could be to gain more muscle mass or, you know, gain muscle while losing fat and all that kind of stuff. That's also very interesting. Do that when you're at that point, but don't do it when you're simply just trying to lose weight. I cannot stress it enough. I think that is ruining a lot of the experiences for people out there because they think, oh, I have to count macros and this many grams of fat and protein. I need this much and carbohydrates. Fuck that. I can't touch that. Shut up. It doesn't matter. As long as you eat less calories than you consume, you're good. You're going to lose weight and you can always optimize. You can always learn. You can always figure out on the fly what works for you. So that is basically my, you know, take on losing weight. Maybe I didn't do it the most healthy way, but I did in a way that allowed me to be where I am today, and I've learned from my mistakes. I did mistakes. I had periods, you know, where I was losing 5 kilos of weight in a month, and then the next month I only lost 1 kilo, or I gained a kilo, so it was up and down, but at the end of the day, over 12 months, I was able to lose 59 kilos, or 60 kilos roughly. So I did it the right way for me, and you guys, again, pause the video and think to yourself, what is the right way for me? What is it that motivates me? Is it playing football? Is it wanting a girlfriend? Is it something else? You gotta figure out what really, 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 really helps you. Now, I hope you guys, first and foremost, enjoyed this long, long monologue of me talking. I'm sorry that it turned out to be so long. I'm having a hard time, you know, I'm having a hard time cooking it down to smaller segments. I wanted to do one long video where I basically just spoke free of my mind. I haven't noted anything down. I haven't written a manuscript or anything like that. I'm basically just talking from my heart right now about what I feel about losing weight, you know, and hopefully you guys have been able to relate to some of the stuff that I've said throughout this video. Now, I want to finish off this video with a few, dare I say, tips and tricks, or at least a few, you know, learnings that I had while losing weight, while exercising, and all that kind of stuff. Maybe, again, something you guys can relate to, and maybe something you guys can't relate to. First and foremost, it's not a secret that I am very active now. It's not a secret that I do a lot of sports now, and I love it. I absolutely love to do sports, you know, whether that is something as silly as, let's have a look at this, something as silly as wood chucking, you know, with your friends right here. That's fun. It's an activity and you have a good time, you know, going out here, sailing the canoe, whatever, you know, playing football. It can be plenty of stuff. I absolutely love being active. Here's another great example of some of the inspiration you can find on my Instagram as well. Going for a run, you name it. Now, one of the learnings I had while losing weight, something you have to be careful with, is that when you are weighing 130 kilos or when you're overweight, your body is carrying on a lot of extra weight, which means that it's under a lot of stress. It's under a lot of stress, which means that you cannot allow yourself to run every day for six days a week. Your body will get injured. So I was suffering from a lot of injuries. I had shin splints. I had, you know, quads that was just tied up. I had legs that wouldn't work. My arms was messed up when I started going to the gym. So one of the learnings that I would have liked to had before I started losing weight or while I was doing it is that you gotta listen to your body more, right? It's nice to see the scale go down, but if the consequence is that you can't move the following week, then there's only so much you can do with your food. You need food, you need nutrition to stay alive and feel fresh in your head, you know, and able to go to school and able to play Counter-Strike for my liking at a high level. Gotta be concentrated mentally, I gotta be aware. So if I would have known that, you know, gotta listen to your body, you gotta not overdo it in the beginning, you gotta start from down here, think about it, right? You're starting from all the way down here and then you're slowly but surely adding layers so you can get up here where you can allow yourself, you know, to go for a run every second day or whatever that may be. So that is a learning, that is a thing that I would say to you guys out there, be careful with this. You cannot allow yourself to injure yourself too much. There'll be injuries, especially in my case, because I was as big as I were and I wanted to bike, I wanted to go for a walk, I wanted to go for the runs, but listen to your body and try to minimize those injuries as well. Another good tip, as I talked about the whole Pepsi Mac thing, you know, cut your calories where you can. Think to yourself, is this really necessary? A great example could be, you know, Pepsi Max. It's a fantastic example. Is it really worth it to, you know, in one can of Coca-Cola, for example, there could be 130, 150 calories in it, right? And you drink that in 5-10 minutes, depending on how fast you're drinking it. Are those 150 calories really worth it if the alternative is drinking a Coca-Cola Light, which you may not like as much, but you save yourself 150 calories, right? You gotta put it up like that. Find alternatives to what you're doing right now. When you want a snack, a great example I did a lot, you know, a plate of Marabou or a plate of Kit Kat or a plate of Toblerone, you know, any given chocolate out there who tastes wonderful. I love chocolate. Is it really worth it if you eat a plate of Marabou and that's 500 calories? That could be up to, you know, 25% of your daily calorie intake, depending on if you're a girl, a male, and how active you are. 25% of what you're supposed to get in terms of nutrition through food can be eaten in 5 minutes, just, you know, snacking on a Marabou bar. Is that really worth it? Think about it like that. Find an alternative. You know, I went for a protein bar. I took a protein bar, I cut it out in pieces, you know, like it was chocolate. Of course it doesn't taste as good as a plate of Marabou. That's just, you know, how God made this shit work, you know. It's not as good as it could be, but it's an alternative. You still get that satisfaction of eating something you think tastes somewhat good, and you save yourself the calories. So, you know, try to wrap your head around finding alternatives for what you do right now in terms of cutting down on the calories. Great learning, great tip. Another one, I also talked about it, don't eat yourself full every single time you eat. You've heard it a million times before probably, and that is one of the like self-proclaimed fitness dudes out there, the best tip, or the weight loss gurus, the best tips they can do is don't eat yourself full every time you eat. And I would agree with that. You don't need to feel like, ugh, I can't eat no more, you know, my stomach hurts. That's not needed, you know. You can eat to the point where you're like, okay, I'm good now. I'm not gonna be hungry for the next 3 hours, or I can go to bed without feeling hungry. I'm good now, you know. So see if you can control that, you know, control how much you eat, control how many calories, of course, you consume, but it's, I guess, a given fact that the less you eat, the less calories you consume. So it could be just, you know, not taking that extra half portion that is saving you 200 calories to make sure that you are at 200 or 2,300 calories as a daily intake. You're burning 2,800, which means that you're in a deficit of 500 calories. That's great, but if you took that extra half portion, which could have been 300 calories, you'd only be in a deficit of 200 calories, which means that it would take you twice the time to lose the same amount of weight. That is another thing you can think about. Last thing and last good learning and last topic I guess I want to cover with this one is one that is related a lot to you guys hopefully watching out there. My audience, I would like to expand it, of course. I would like it to be everyday people who think what I'm doing and what I stand for is interesting. I'm trying a lot to be a positive influence within my community, which is the gaming community. But another thing I want to say straight, I guess, to you guys is that you can play a lot of computer games. You can play professional Counter-Strike while also eating well, while also being healthy. Me traveling the world, me having 200 travel days a year is not an excuse not for being healthy. I can find alternatives when I'm in an airport. Do I go to the burger place or do I grab a sandwich? We can both agree that the burger is 10 times better than a shitty sandwich from an airport. But sometimes you gotta contain yourself. Sometimes you gotta have the goal for eyes, sort of, right? You gotta look towards the future and think, future Jacob, would he be happy about you eating a burger right now? No, he'd be pissed. You know, present Jacob would be happy for the burger right now, but if you just eat that sandwich, then future Jacob is gonna be happy for you. And after all, that's a better feeling, I guess. Think like that, you know, see if you can find alternatives. There's no excuse. Same comes with playing computer games. You can sit in front of your PC. You can practice 5 hours, 6 hours, 7 hours a day and still be healthy. You just make sure that when you're not practicing at your PC, go to the gym, go for a bike ride, go for, you know, for an activity. Make sure when you have those 5 hours in your seat, like I do every day when I'm streaming, make sure to have once or twice during those, you know, 2 or 3, 5, 6 hours, whatever that may be, go up, you know, do 10 push-ups, you know, do 10 jumping jacks, do something, get your heart rate up and just, you know, be a little bit more active. You may burn 30, 50 calories, you know, if you do that a couple of times a day, but those 30 or 50 calories could be the difference between you gaining weight or you losing weight, right? That's how closely narrowed it is, especially if you do it on a consistent basis. So don't think, people out there, don't think you cannot play professional Counter-Strike. Don't think you have to accept an unhealthy lifestyle just because you want to be a professional Counter-Strike player. I think I am, and I don't like saying this because it sounds super, super arrogant, but I think I'm one of the greatest examples within the esports community that you can make that transition. You can make the transition from being a big guy, a fat guy, a guy that is not comfortable around himself or around anyone else, to be a healthy guy that is, you know, filled with confidence, filled with life, I guess, filled with energy. That's the energy that I'm doing to make this video. That's the energy I'm doing to stream every day. You know, you can make that transition while also achieving a career as a professional Counter-Strike player. My best year of Counter-Strike, if you look at my statistics, if you look at the period when some of the experts, when some of the people around the world were saying, okay, Jacob, right now, the way he's playing, he's one of the 15, 20 best rifle players in the entire world playing Counter-Strike. Well, that was while I was losing weight. That was in the process of losing weight. For me, that is extremely important to manifest. For me, that's extremely important to say that you can achieve whatever goals you want to while losing weight. You can accomplish your best while losing weight. Whether that is being the best you've ever been on a football pitch, whether that is being the best you've ever been in a handball game, whether that is being the best Fortnite player you've ever been, whether that's being the best Call of Duty player, best Counter-Strike player, I don't give a flying damn about whatever you want to achieve. You should care about that. You should achieve whatever you want to achieve. All I'm saying is that losing weight and being in the process of losing weight ain't no excuse for not losing it. Ain't no excuse for not doing it. Ain't no excuse for not, you know, achieving, dare say, greatness outside of your office, outside of the computer, all that kind of stuff. I think that, to me, is extremely important to say, because there's been so many guys asking, well, how could you do that while also playing? Well, how can you eat while also being a professional Counter-Strike player? How can you do your laundry while also being a professional Counter-Strike player? How do you vacuum and clean your apartment while also being a professional Counter-Strike player? You make it a habit. It's something you have to do, and you achieve something for it, right? When you clean your apartment, you don't live in a mess. You feel good, smells clean. When you go do your workouts, you feel good. You get in a better shape and you feel clean. Your body is clean. The feeling you have inside your body feels clean. So there is no excuse not to do that. And I think that, to me, is a very, very important thing to say and a very important thing to stress out, that there's no excuse. There's no, I have this job, so I can't do that. Well, there's always a way. You gotta find alternatives. You gotta find ways around it, and you gotta be creative with it. And then you gotta, motivate yourself. Set up some goals, I want to be able to do 10 push-ups every time I go out of the office and do push-ups. Next time, you can do 11. Time after that, a few months, you do 15. And after a year, you do 56 push-ups whenever you do push-ups. You're transitioning. You're getting better. You're achieving something. So set up goals as well. Easily a motivational factor of achieving something. I think that'd be it. I think you guys have listened enough and seen enough of my stupid-ass face with glasses right here. I hope, sincerely, that you guys got something out of this video. I hope so much that you guys learned stuff from this video, or at least that you thought to yourself, okay, this I can relate to. I don't care if you can relate to the entire video, it doesn't matter to me. You can think that I'm an idiot, you can think whatever you want of me, but if this has helped just 1, 2, 3, maybe even a couple of 100 guys of you watching just relate to one of the few examples that I've given, then I am all happy, and I think this would have been worth it. I can feel that I'm getting a little bit, wouldn't necessarily say emotional, but I'm getting rattled up. This is a video that I've been wanting to do for a while, so it would mean the world to me if you guys, given the fact that you like it, that may not be a given, of course, given the fact you do like it, share it with your friends, share it with your, it could be your family, share it with some of your classmates, share it with someone that you want to help, or someone you think could use my perspective of what it is being healthy. That could be within the Call of Duty community, the Fortnite community. It could be, on some of the Danish CSGO communities. It could be in your local Indonesian CSGO community. I don't know. Wherever in this world there's a person that potentially could benefit from spending 45, 46, 47 minutes listening to my stupid face talking, I would love if you guys would do that. Share it and spread the word out there, because it is close to me, right? It is something that I've been experiencing. I've been on both sides. I've been the big guy. I've been the healthy guy. I have a lot of respect for people who go through weight loss. I have a lot of respect for people who want to lose weight, but they cannot do it. They can't find a way to motivate themselves. When I'm done playing Counter-Strike, when I'm done streaming, when I'm done, doing all the stuff that I have goals in right now, I wouldn't mind being a guy who dedicated my life to help others to achieve some of the stuff that I've achieved, because I can, bottom of my heart, say that this is one of the best feelings that I've ever had. If this is one of the most pride feelings I've ever had. My dad passed away, unfortunately, 2 years ago. And if you asked him, what he's the most proud of about his son, I don't think he's the most proud of him being a professional Counter-Strike player. He was proud of that. He couldn't stop telling his friends that I made a living of playing Counter-Strike. But if he had to pinpoint one thing, I am 100% sure that he's proud of the transition I had going from being a very uncomfortable guy to be around, and a very uncomfortable guy in my own body, to be a guy that is filled with excitement for life, that is filled with energy, that is filled with all the stuff that I'm filled with, water, blood, whatever that's inside me, bones. I think you'd be proud of that, and I think you guys should give yourself the chance of achieving the same thing if that is what you want to do. You do whatever is best for yourself, you do whatever you feel comfortable with, but I hope that I've played just a tiny, tiny part, or a small, small part, in hopefully pushing you in the right direction. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to stop by my Instagram. Don't forget to hook me up with a follow on Twitter. Stop by the stream if you want to ask more about, the weight loss thing. If there's something I didn't cover in this video, you're more than welcome to comment down below. In fact, I would love if you did. Leave a like, leave a subscription, all the stuff you say when you're a YouTuber nowadays. You guys have a good one.